ATM networks are different from the typical Ethernet network we have already discussed. For one thing, ATM uses special signaling between switches, and this is something not found in Ethernet. This signaling, or communication exchange between ATM devices, is ATM's way of sharing information across the network. Two types of signaling are used in ATM communication. One type, called user-to-network interface, or unisignaling, allows end stations to communicate with their local switch. Another type of signaling, called network-to-network interface signaling, or just NNI signaling, supports communication between switches. Here's a large ATM network. Some of the ports are configured to communicate with unisignaling, and other ports are configured to use NNI signaling. NNI signaling is often written as PNNI, with the P standing for private. PNNI is a special kind of signaling used within corporate networks. Corporate networks are considered private networks when compared to the public networks, like the public phone system that telecommunication companies build. Now, you might ask yourself, if PNNI stands for private NNI, how do you abbreviate a public NNI? Well, you got me there. Just to help confuse the issue, since public begins with P2, public NNI is also written as PNNI, though a friend of mine insists on calling the public version of NNI puny. However, since most of the networks we are discussing are private networks, 95% of the time PNNI will identify a private network. And I'll be sure to be specific when this is not the case.